The past few weeks we've been making the film of Shanghai Surprise, which is the new film starring Madonna and Sean Penn. And as you'll have seen from the press in the last week or so, it's been absolutely appalling. So we're here to talk a little bit about that aspect of things with the executive producer of the film, George Harrison.
Well, good evening, Tubes.
It's been blown up out of proportion, I would have thought, a bit over the last week.
Yes, well, it's the sort of thing they do, isn't it? The press are that way inclined, you know, when they get onto something, it's like a sort of fox hunt, you know, they smell blood and they all go the yahoo over the hedges with their knives. But it is ridiculous. It's got a bit ridiculous because, first of all, Sean and Madonna were never in the contract. They never said they were going to be doing press. It's only the fact that she is a pop star, which is the hand, you know. But, I mean, if you look at all the other movies and movie actors, I mean, you don't exactly have a lot of interviews with Robert Redford or Robert De Niro or any of those people. It's not a part of making a movie doing the press. Maybe at a given time you have a press conference or you put out publicity shots, but most actors just don't do interviews, and they're up at 5 a.m. in the morning, working till 8 o'clock at night, and they're knackered, you know, by the end of the day. They don't want to be out there saying, oh, yes, well, you know, and then I recorded this song.
Do you think it would have been any better if they'd have both decided to do something right at the beginning of making the film to keep everyone happy? Do you think it's just because they've been kept
hiding
in bushes for weeks on end?
They haven't been hiding in bushes, though. They've just been getting made up and doing the shots and then having their lunch. I don't think so, you know, in this situation. I mean, I'm gonna say it's probably like, you know, it's Madonna mania. And when that situation arises, there's no way, no amount of press, because you give them one thing and they want more. You know, I'm sure after the press conference, there's probably gonna be certain people of the press who are gonna still be hanging about trying to get more pictures, because they sell them to all these magazines and stuff. They make a living out of it.
How much has it actually affected the making of the film?
Well, we've had a few mornings that we've lost, because especially after the Daily Express, you know, Sean was, it's very difficult, you know, if you get emotionally upset and then you expect it to walk on a camera and be happy. So he needed a bit of time to cool down after that, but we had a few delays, but it is a very tight schedule. And the main thing is, the film is very nice, it looks great. So all this is just like secondary aggravation. The main thing that we're doing is trying to make a good film, and so far, even with the hassles, you know, it looks very good.
You said that Sean had lost a morning a couple of days ago because of the Express. How much does it actually affect them both, and how much are they being protected against what's written, or do they just see it all? Are you trying to hide things from Sean a bit?
No. I've told him, you know, what you have to do is either not read the papers or have the ability, when you do read them, to just ignore it, because most of the public, I don't think the public actually believes all that stuff, you know? But they did it to us in the 60s. They build you up. They gave us more publicity than we were, that was, you know, justifiable. And then, when they build you up that big, the only thing left to do is put the boot in. And it just happens that she's, you know, big enough for them to feel they want to do that. It's a shame, really, when you get President Marcus and, you know, Colonel Gaddafi, you know, and they give them wonderful coverage. And these people who are actually quite nice people, and they're treated like rats. Showbiz, no business like show business.
You've been very involved, though, all the time, over the last few weeks that we've been here. You've been around a lot. Are you normally this involved, or have you had to be extra involved?
I'm extra involved, anyway, because first of all, I'm doing the music to the film, and so I need to be around more to know more about the atmosphere that the music's going to create along with the visual. And also because I think it's fortunate, really, that I'm in some way more able to relate to Sean and Madonna, because, you know, my past whatever that was.
What do you think will happen next? Do you think it will just all go quite smoothly from now on?
Well, I think we've done our best with the press conference, and you know, I think I hope it does. Yeah, but you can't guarantee it because some of these press are loonies. They are loonies. I mean, they're like that guy who's on the front windshield of their car, trying to get pictures through the window as the car's pulling away, and then he complains that he falls off the car.
He actually got his glimpses.
And they all use a photograph of the fella lying on the floor, but they don't show a photo of him actually being a menace to society. You know, I have no sympathy for people like that.
Have they done anything very ingenious, the press, so far?
Well, stolen the photographs from the continuity lady. That's...
They broke the lady's toilet.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a lot of interesting. That's probably going to be the soundtrack album.
How much longer is there to go?
It's about 4 weeks shooting now.
Are you going to be relieved?
Well, yeah. I'd like to see it all finished, all the shooting, because it'd be nice to see a rough cut of the film, you know, and the rough assembly, and get back in the studio and make up some music.
Some tunes.
And then I got to do your garden.